When I first met Damien, he was not a rock star. He was making just enough money to be to just scraping by.
Schöne Grüße aus Frankfurt, aus dem Ramada Hotel Frankfurt Messe. Ja, unser Tool, Ihr erster Blick, ist jetzt verfügbar im Backoffice von mir.
Herzlich willkommen in Las Vegas, Wunderland.
Ich kann gerne euch meinen Traum zeigen, den ich gefunden habe. Und zwar sprechen wir über einen Geländewagen, einen Lamborghini Urus.
I'm not like one of y'all. I'm from the jungle. I run with the son of God. Yeah. What is you running for? They should be running for me.
Hello, everybody, and welcome. Good evening to this very special Unstoppable webinar. I'm really, really excited to be here. We are a small but privileged group tonight, and we're going to work on our business, and we're going to talk about some of the keys for success in network marketing. In fact, I call them the six keys to excellence. Before I get started, I want to say thank you to Leonor and Rahma that are being translating this webinar to French and also to Portuguese. So we have a trilingual webinar here tonight. And we are also going to record this, but we're only going to have the English version being recorded, okay? So if you want to use the moment and promote the webinar and get some more people on from your team, this is the moment to do it, because in just a few minutes from now, we're going to be rocking and rolling. But before we get into the topic, I want to say, first of all, that I'm really excited to be here with you. And obviously, I want to see where's everybody logging in from. So why don't you just put in the chat and we win some minutes for people that are still coming on. Where's everybody from right now? Okay, we got some people from India, from the UK. Nice. Hemant in Dubai, Turkey, Birmingham, Ireland, South London, Angola. Welcome. Italy. Nice, nice. Portugal. We have more India, Portugal, UK. Well, it seems like we got the right crowd, okay? We got the right crowd. Most of you speak English, Portuguese, or French, so that's good. Mozambique, North Wales, all right, welcome, why not? Paris, beautiful. I'd like to be in Paris right now, to be honest. I love Paris. Awesome, all right. Let's get started. This is actually a very special presentation that I did on my most recent trip to Lebanon, when I was really thinking about, okay, if I were to have the opportunity to share with people just a handful of keys that I believe make a major difference in your business. And also when I think about my story and I look at the big points that I would contribute the success to, then those are the keys, okay? Those are the keys. So I really believe every single key is gonna help you unlock that next level of business. Before I get into the keys, I wanna talk to you real quick about my story for those people that don't know. I know most of you do know my story, but just really, really quick. So I got started when I was 18 years old in Germany. I'm German. I live in Dubai now for about 8 years. When I got started, for me, network marketing was just a dream. You know, it was a dream. It was almost like a big game. I remember telling my dad one day in the beginning, oh my God, Dad, this feels like a game. It's like a game, but in like the real world, right? And from these initial ideas of network marketing today, I built a huge organization. In fact, we all together built a huge organization that's called Unity Global. We have more than 1 million members now, people that have paid an order at least once, right? So we've reached a small country level size if everybody were to come together. We're operating our business, our organization, in more than 11 languages at this point. We have big, big infrastructure, amazing webinars coming up. One thing I didn't promote it yet, but 99% it's confirmed that after tomorrow night, we're going to make a live global run call with Scott Lewis. So clear your calendars for that one. Okay, it's going to be midnight Dubai time, 10 p.m. CEST, 9 p.m. UK, Netherlands, and wherever you guys are residing in, okay? That's on Friday. Hopefully, that's going to be confirmed in the next few minutes. And much more to come. We have an amazing event coming up in Dubai in November, the Unity Global Convention. If you don't have your ticket yet, this is the time. We are practically sold out, but there is always a way to get you guys in. You can find all the information at ugconvention2021.com. So UG as in Unity Global, ugconvention2021.com. It is going to be spectacular. Our organization today is doing business in more than 100 countries. We have millions of dollars of sales, not per year, not per month, but sometimes per week. Okay. Every month, multiple millions at this point. And again, some weeks that are crazy performing, we actually even have multiple millions of sales in a single week. So it's all quite fascinating. Our goal is to reach $100 million this year. Big boys business. That's the target. And then eventually to become a billion-dollar team. Now, how do we do that? We do that by raising up leadership. We do that by helping people be successful in this ecosystem, okay? In this world of Jeunesse. And I know that a lot of you guys that are online here have high aspirations. I saw some of the names when I went through the list, and man, there are some people that I know for many, many years, whether it's from Portugal, whether it's from Dubai, whether it's some other new people that just joined us, you know, from India or from the UK. I know some of you really have that big, big vision and that big dream. So I hope that tonight is going to be an amazing night for you guys, taking some keys for your business to take it to the next level. And let's jump right in. The first one is work hard. And I know this is such a simple, basic thing. We always hear it, but I want to talk about working hard just a little bit because, you know, what I found is that most people actually don't work hard. I don't know, call me crazy, but I think most people do not work hard. A lot of people say that they work a lot. A lot of people actually even think that they work a lot, but really they don't. And you only realize that you are not working so hard if you do one of two things. Either you track your activity. So let's say, for example, let's make an easy example. One of our key to-dos every day, part of our daily method of operation, I guess, is to talk to people, right? I mean, making the invitations, showing the plan, you know, making a presentation, sharing the products. That's a very basic to-do in our business. And if you were to think or even ask yourself, okay, how many people did you do that with the last month, let's say? Okay, let's say this month so far. Okay. How many people have you actually invited personally to have a look at the business? How many people have you presented the opportunity or the product? Usually what we guess, the number that we guess is so much higher than the real number. We think it's like, oh my God, it must be like at least 20, 30 people, right? I mean, easily. But if you actually start to track it, you will find that you talk a lot with your team. You talk a lot with people that you already invited before. You have a lot of conversation with maybe somebody that's also in Jeunesse. But really, if you were to track the new invitations per day, the new conversation that you start per day, it's so little. For most of you, it's not even going to be one a day. Most people that I find are inviting about 5 to 7 people a month. And that's just not enough, right? So that's just not enough. So when we talk about working hard, then that has something to do with being organized and with also tracking the productive activity. And don't get me wrong, if you add new people to your conversation list every day, that means your list of follow-ups that's required on the next day and the next day and the next day is growing. And that's why when I say working hard, it really means literally that, because it becomes a lot of work. And I want to tell you something about that, because and then I'm going to get into the second thing I'm not forgetting about how to find out if you're actually working hard. When I did my first 90-day run, it's an interesting thing because right now we're in a 90-day run and a lot of people are asking, what is it? Like, I mean, I understand now we're all in and stuff, right? But what do I have to do? Like, what are you doing in the 90-day run? I can tell you guys the exact same thing that we're always doing. We're not doing anything new. We're not all of a sudden, I don't know, handing out magazines on the street or in the malls or something like that, you know? Like, we're doing the same thing, which is to make invitations, to show the product, to show the plan, to make calls with the team, to fill the calendar, all the stuff we're always doing, using the products, all these things, you know, promoting the business and the brand. But you do it with a different level of intensity. And what I found one time when I did my first 90-day run, I didn't really know this idea of really, like, you know, going all in and eliminate all distractions and really just work. That was something that I didn't know if people are going to like that or if anybody was going to be as crazy as I was and ready to do this. So I said, okay, worst case, if nobody will work with me alongside at that level, then at least I'm going to have somehow a backup plan for myself. Like, what am I going to do worst case, right? Nobody does anything. Everybody's just like, you guys are crazy, right? So what am I going to do? And back then I decided, okay, worst case, if nobody does nothing, I'm going to make 10 invitations a day. And I don't know, that doesn't even sound so much, right? But 10 a day is quite a lot. And if you do that over 90 days, we're talking about 900 conversations. I've never seen a person introducing the business personally, one by one, to 900 people in 3 months. I've never seen this before. Because also logically, if you were to do that, you would sign up about 1 out of 10. That's usually what we say. If you're really good, maybe you sign up 2 out of 10, right? But you'll enroll about 90 to 100 people minimum. I've never seen anybody enrolling 90 to 100 people in 90 days. That by itself would be a game changer, right? So that's why I said, that sounds like a good plan. So worst case, if nobody does nothing, at least I'm going to enroll 100 people frontline in 90 days and I'm going to be just a legend in the company because nobody ever did this. So I loved my plan, right? So I got started with my run and I did the call and I promoted the story to the team. And I, you know, I wrote down my list and I took the first 100 people from my list and I sent everybody a message personalized and I got the conversation going and all. And then the next day I found, wow. So yesterday I initiated a conversation with 100 people. The next day has come. Now, what do I have to do? Exactly. Follow up. With whom? Well, all of them. There we go. So now I had a problem. I just started 100 conversations yesterday. So today I had to do 100 follow-ups. And guess what? I had to add another 10. And the next day I had to add another 10. And the next day I had to add another 10. And I had another 10 follow-ups and another 20 follow-ups, another 30 follow-ups. I am challenging you to do 130 follow-ups in one day. You realize what it means to work hard, okay? And I'm not going to go into the basics of the business now on how to follow up or how to invite or how to promote or how to present. This is all very, very basic network marketing skill set training, which is very important, like extremely important. But you can all learn that. We have so many webinars about that, so many trainings. A lot of you know it anyways. There is a book you can read from Eric Worre called GoPro. It's all in there. But now we're just focusing on this point of being willing to work hard. Because if you say, listen, I want my business to move, then you need to be willing to work hard and to do that amount of conversations, like in a run like now, for example, is not easy. And it's easier to not do it. And even if you're not in a run and we look at things more normal and you say, okay, look, I'm going to do 3 invitations a day. No problem. Just 3 a day, right? Okay. So you do that for a week. Now you still have 15 people on your follow-up list on Friday. And you have to still add another three and still add another three and still add another three. And the list is growing. And yes, once in a while, somebody drops off the list by saying, really, this is not for me. Thank you. And I'm not interested. Maybe somebody will say, listen, I'm on holidays now, but call me on the 20th. Okay, perfect. You can put them on hold for your follow-up. You don't want to annoy people, right? But ultimately, your follow-up list is growing. It's not decreasing. And in my general rule is I'll do a daily follow-up. If I'm in the process of recruiting somebody, I'm going to talk to them every day. That's just my rule, right? Every day, at least once. And so that point is pretty legitimate. So here's my advice number one, track it, write it down. Because many times the conversations we have is, yeah, you worked an hour of the business, but really you were talking 1 hour to a downline of yours, right? Or you were doing your follow-ups, which is good, but then where are the new invitations? Where's the fresh blood, right? So this is all very important. The second way to find out if you're working hard or not is to just, when you look at people, if you're ever in the environment where someone else is working hard, like very hard, then you can see, oh shoot, I'm not doing that. You know what I mean? So, that's not always a given, but sometimes if you have the chance to like look at the agenda of one of your uplines or leaders, or when you see the amount of, I'm just grabbing a neutral example here for us right now, because let me talk about a guy that's not in the upline of anybody from you guys. So just my friend Andreas from Germany, right? Just for example, he's a diamond on the way to go double diamond. I know that right now he's in north of Italy and he's literally locked in with two of his leaders, and morning till night, they are doing presentations. I know that he's probably showing the plan 7 times a day right now. Another guy, Michael from Austria, he's running for Emerald this month. I know that he's having more than 14 meetings per day, like right now. Once you witness something like that, then you're like, wow, right? If I look at some of my friends from the Middle East, that they're doing meetings at 4:30 in the morning. It's just another level of commitment, right? And I'm not saying you have to always do that, but when there is a time that you want to break through, working hard is actually something that is unpopular to talk about because it's not sexy, right? But trust me, working hard makes a big difference, okay? And that's the first thing. And in my life, the truth is I've never been afraid to work hard. I've never been afraid to work hard. In fact, for me, somehow I'm wired differently. If I don't work, I feel bad. And it's not that I cannot enjoy. It's just I love the progress, right? I'm in love with the progress. Progress equals happiness. And if I don't work, I'm not progressing. So I want to progress, and therefore I work. And that's the beautiful thing about this, right? So even like, let's say now to make this call after having all these meetings and conversations today, it's another 45 minutes of work, another 45 minutes of putting energy. But I love to put the plant in all of you guys' heads. And I know that somewhere it's going to find root and it's going to grow. And maybe one day somebody's going to say, hey, you'll not believe it, but that one day in August when you did that event at night, we're just a small group of people. That was the game changer for me. That happens. Perfect, right? That's the reason why I'm doing this webinar right now, so that someone will take it and just do something big with it. And those are just some ideas, but it's a very special presentation because I've never done it before except once in Lebanon. So working hard. The second thing is the mindset. It's absolutely critical, not just what you do, but what you think about while you're doing it. It does matter. Because imagine, if you're recruiting, you're talking to somebody, and in your mind, you're like, if I sign up this person, it's perfect. I'm going to make $250 in sign-up bonus, right? How do you think your success is going to be? How do you think your thoughts, even though you're smart and you're not saying it, how do you think non-verbally the other person will feel in that conversation? Do you think they feel it's not really about them, but it's really about you? I think they do. In fact, I know they do. even if maybe you're good and can talk well, ultimately it's a different conversation whether you're making this phone call, this conversation, this presentation for you to make money, or whether you do it because you really believe in somebody. If you really believe in somebody, if you really want to work with somebody, if you really think this person has skills and qualities and needs they can fulfill with this business, if you really have a vision, if you really respect this person, that if you really are a fan of the person you're trying to recruit, it's a different conversation. And it starts the way you think. Okay? Now, next thing about mindset is building a business is not easy. Any business is not easy, really. Network marketing, yeah, we can discuss whether it's simple, but it's certainly not easy. What I mean by simple is that, well, technically it's easy, because what do you have to do? Well, you can either sign up a customer or you can sign up a distributor. I don't know if there's anything else you can do. I don't think so, because ultimately the only thing we can do is find a new customer or sign up a new distributor. And yeah, you can talk to your team to do the same thing, but really that's the essence of our business, right? And I don't even think you'll find another thing to do. That's all you can do. You can find a customer and find a distributor and find a customer and find a distributor. And if everybody just found new customers and new distributors every day, the world will be great. So technically it's very easy, but I know it's not easy. Therefore I say it's simple. It's simple. It's pretty basic to understand. But then it's not easy at all. And the reason why it's not easy at all is because as an entrepreneur, or also as a network marketer, you're facing a lot of challenges, difficulties, rejections, people that say no, hopes and aspirations that get fully, how to say in English, disappointed. Like, let's say, for example, when I got started, I thought, really, I was sure I'm going to enroll at least 100 people next week. At least. The guy on the event was saying, how many people do you know that want to make money? And I was saying, well, everybody? Isn't everybody want to make money? But then I found, when I told people about my plan, that they have another plan. They're not interested. They're whatever, afraid, negative, skeptical. That was so weird. My high hopes and expectations that I had were completely disappointed. Nothing of that happened. And whether the same happened to you or not, we all will face disappointments in this business. Maybe people promise stuff, they don't keep it. Maybe you drive to a meeting and nobody shows up. Maybe a person will say, yeah, I'll sign up tomorrow, and they won't. Maybe some of your friends are going into a witness protection program and you can't even reach them anymore. It's like they disappeared. Come on, guys. Have you ever had that? You were really trying to just show somebody and they disappeared on you. Have you ever had that? Come on, please show me. Please show me I'm not the only person. Write in the chat. Happened to Sarah. Thank you. Preta. Perfect. Sarah. Sarah double. Hemant, Christina. All right. Happened to me too. Where the heck have they gone? Don't worry about it. But here's the thing. So it's not what happens to you that will determine your success, because all that stuff happened to me. We can go on and on and on and on and on. People that were asking for money never paid it back. We can go on and on and on and on. People that said, oh, I was going to do this, and they never did it. We can go on about mistakes that the company did. We can go on about mistakes people did. We can go on about mistakes we did. All of this is going to happen. You ask any leader, they all had difficulties. They all had challenges. They all had disappointments. They all had unfair situations. But guess what? I just said all successful people had that. Well, that implies that now they're successful. So it's not about what happened to them. It's how they dealt with it. So what is important is the way you deal with your problems, with your challenges, with your scenarios. And there's so many things we could talk, like we could make a 2-day training about the mindset. But for example, in the beginning, you are completely overestimating the importance of events. So your best friend is totally excited. Next day they call and they say, oh, I read on the internet and, you know, it's a scam and I'm not going to do it. And you're literally breaking down, like emotionally, because you had the high hopes. Oh my God, we're going to kill this together. The whole night you couldn't sleep. Next day, boom, your aspirations and dreams shattered on the floor. And then some people quit. They say, oh my God, I can't do it because my best friend's not joining. And it sounds a little bit funny now, but in reality, it's not funny. In reality, it's crushing, right? But the truth is, it doesn't matter at all. In if you really go diamond on the day you do, you forgot about this. So sometimes it's important to ask yourself, the problem that I'm dealing with right now, does it really matter in 10 years from now? And many times the answer is nope. Will I even remember this situation? Probably not. Right. So that's and it's important to know that and to focus on that and to make sure that you are getting your mind right. How to do that? First of all, to emotionally disconnect from the outcome. Don't like do your best with what you have. Don't complain about what you don't have. Have a no problem attitude and just work hard. Always believe the best. Always look for what works, not for what doesn't work. Always stay positive and excited, regardless what happens. That's when you adopt a winning mindset. Make sense? Okay. And the difference between people that do that and don't is so evident. Like there's a group of people that will tell you every single day why it doesn't work. And guess what? They'll never be successful. Because they'll tell you all day why it doesn't work. We need to be the people that tell each other that it does work and what works and why it matters that it works. That's important. And we need to believe in people. And we need to believe in our customers. And we need to believe in our company. And we need to believe in ourselves. And all of this is very, very important. Next thing, consistency. Consistency is another thing. So many people, when they're hyped up, they do the activity, right? They, after the event, oh my God, activity is going crazy. At the end of the month, activity is going crazy. At the end of a promotion, activity is going through the roof. All of a sudden, everybody knows how to do volume. But the whole rest of the time, somehow not, right? So, and here's the truth about non-consistency. There is a rule which I call, well, I don't know how I call it in English, to be honest. I'm just realizing I have a German name for it. Die Dreifachregel in German, for those that speak German. So the 3X, let's call it the 3X rule. Okay, so not 10X like Grant Cardone, okay, but the 3X rule. And it says this: if you are not doing anything for one day, it'll take you 3 days to get back on track. If you're not doing anything for 1 week, it's going to take you 3 weeks to get back on track. If you've been kind of switched off for 2 months, well, guess what? It's going to take you half a year to be back at the point where you were 2 months ago. How many of you would agree with this? The threefold rule. How many of you have experienced something like that? You say, that is scary, but that is true. Have you ever, maybe some of you are leaders and you've already built a team, you've already been recruiting. Have you ever stopped recruiting for quite a while and started to feel bad and started to feel non-productive? And then you started to recruit again. Well, in fact, you tried and it was so hard. It was almost like, oh my God, why is it so hard to recruit all of a sudden, right? Like, how, is it really possible that it's so hard? The truth is it's not. It's just you stopped and now you need to rebuild the muscle. If you don't use it, you lose it. Write it down. If you don't use it, you lose it. And yes, it's the same with workout or deadlifting or anything. Like if you stop, my God, it is so hard to get back. So here's what you need to do. Build better habits and better consistency. Because see, any single action that you're going to do, listen to this carefully, any single action you're going to do from this today is not going to make you successful. There's absolutely nothing you can do to go diamond like this. You just can't. Because there's not a magic pill, a one-line solution. There is not, if you do this tomorrow, you're a diamond. No. Realistically, there's absolutely no chance. The only chance that you have is by doing the right things consistently over time. Because over time, what repetitive actions are going to do, first of all, they're going to build you. You see, what do you think is more powerful? When you do 300 invitations, so let's say you do three a day for 90 days or 100 days, that's 300 invitations. Yes, you're going to recruit 30 of them, and that's great. And you're probably going to go Sapphire 25 with doing that. But Sapphire 25 is possibly not changing your life. And if you were to stop after this, it won't probably even be sustainable. But the more powerful thing that happens of doing 300 invitations is that you are being built to be the best inviter. If you do 300 invitations, you know how to do it. You just built your skill, okay? And also you built your habit. If you do three a day for 100 days, it will feel very awkward not to do it. It's something that comes easy to you then. Let's talk about this for a second. If I talk to a whole crowd of people right now and say, hey guys, here's what we're gonna do, three invitations a day, who's in? Everybody's gonna say, oh yeah, I'm in, I'm gonna do it, I'll do it. I'm telling you, not 15 days into the challenge, 99% of people are dropped out and they haven't done it. 99% of people. Why? Because it's so hard. But it's only hard if you don't have the habit. If you've been doing it for 100 days every day, oh, easy, you just keep doing it. And the gym is really a very good example to that. How come that some people, they get to a place where they say, I can't live without a gym. Like I travel, first thing I check, where's the gym? Like if I'm not moving, I just don't feel right. I wish I had that. I don't have that. And you know why I don't have that? Because I never really built the habit. I tried a couple of times, but ultimately my why isn't big enough. Maybe one day it will be. It's not right now. And because it isn't, for me, it's so hard. But in network marketing, my why is big enough. I do it every day and it's so easy. For me, it's so easy. I wish I could just transfer that to you. I can't. But what I can tell you is that consistency builds it. Make sense? How's the translation doing, guys? Can you keep up? I'm trying not to be too fast. So if you do things consistently every day, things will become easier. And not because they're really easier, but because you get better. And that's the old saying by the late great Jim Rohn, who said, don't wish for things to be easier. Because why did he say that? Because then success would just be average. You don't want it to be easier. Wish you were better. That's what matters. Exactly. And consistency will build a habit, and a habit will lead to success. What's the next key? Oh, this is a big one. The minimum disease. Now, in times of COVID, okay, we're all trying to avoid the virus. I just were about to say the flu. We're just all trying to avoid the flu, trying to avoid the COVID virus, okay? And I guess that's a good thing. You don't want to catch it. But I believe there's a much more dangerous virus out there, and it's called the minimum disease. And here's what it is. You can spot it every second, okay? Here's what it is. If you have a prospect and he says, so tell me, Preeta, what's the minimum sign up I have to do? Have you ever had that question? Or maybe you are asking your sponsor, so what is the minimum volume I need to do every month? for my smart delivery, right? Or maybe you say, somebody says, how many hours a day do I have to work in this business? What's the minimum? Did you ever realize that this question sucks? You know why it sucks? Because if you ask for the minimum, what do you think you're gonna get? Exactly, the minimum. I've never seen anybody going outrageously successful with the question, what's the minimum I can use to kind of sneak through the loopholes? That's not how you build a winning business. It's not even about the minimum. You know, when I realized that I deleted the basic package from my presentations, I straight up deleted it. And I said, I'm not going to set up people for failure. I'm not looking for people that want to do the minimum. I'm just not looking for it. I'm looking for people that think bigger. I'm looking for people that believe more. I'm looking for people that are ready to step up. I'm raising the bar. Because if you need just a minimum, there's no need for leadership. There is no, look, I have a sign up sheet, and let's say it says package A, B, and C, right? There is a small one and a middle one and a big one. And now you hand this to 100 people and say, how do you want to get started? No explanation, just like that. What's everybody going to go for? Almost everybody. Small pack, right? Funny, in any country, any culture, regardless how good the pack is, what's the product or even the business, most people, by far, 95% plus, are going to go with the small pack. So if the small pack comes natural to everybody, we have to ask the question why. And it's simple. It's because they have a lack of belief in network marketing, lack of belief in themselves, lack of belief in the business. And that translates into the thought that, okay, if I don't have to risk so much, it's a good thing. And then they try to borrow the missing belief from finding someone else to sign up. So it's kind of like, all right, I'm going to get the smallest pack. I'm not setting up my smart delivery just yet. First, I'm going to try to see if I can find somebody that will join. And if I have, then I will do that. So now a person that is not believing, a person that did not risk anything, a person that is not feeling the fire, trying to talk to somebody else that himself's insecure about how to make money. How good is that going to work? It's not working. It's not working. In fact, what we need is big thinkers, innovators, people that have courage, people that do crazy things, people that are convinced, energetic, passionate. And guess what? If you want to go to the top of the plan, you need to become that person. And if you cannot convince yourself to go bigger, how do you expect to do that with any other person? Example, when I got started with Calvin, my sponsor, in 2010, in September, I asked him, hey, Calvin, how did you get started? And back then we had three packs. It was, you know, the Monavie juice. Not everybody has it. I think UK, you guys are blessed, you have it. Everybody in the Middle East, India, all, you don't have it, unfortunately. But maybe one day you can try it. You have other products we don't have. We don't have it here in the UAE either. But anyways, it's an acai juice. And back then we had mainly this product. So what we said is, okay, you buy 3 cases, 6 cases, or 12 to get started. 3, 6, or 12. And I said to Calvin, hey, how did you get started? And what did he say? Well, he's a millionaire in the business, so he knows what to do. So he said, bro, are you serious? I'm not going to get on a Ferrari with a handbrake on. Of course, with the biggest package. And I said, perfect. So you got 12, right? And I said, okay, cool. So I'm going to get 30. And he said, what? And I said, you had 12, right? So I'm going to get 30. Question, has that ever happened to you? Have you ever like showed somebody the packs and then the person said, what did you do? And you said ambassador and he said, oh, I'll take two. Does that ever happen? No, right? It never happened to me, I swear, never. Okay, but I did it. But why did I do it? That's the magic question. Is it because I had too much money? I'll tell you the truth. I had 7 credit cards, all in debt, like all in debt. 7 cards, almost maxed out. I had about $30,000 in debt, which at the time back then was for me was an impossible number to ever pay back because I had no plan how to do this. So I thought to myself, hey, I rather have $33,000 in debt, but a strong plan than $30,000 without plan. Make sense? But the other part was this. I did that because I wanted to do things differently. I wanted once and for all to break the cycle of being the one who thinks small. And also, to be very honest, I wanted the attention from my sponsor. Telling you the truth. Because I was nobody. And the guy was the youngest millionaire in the company. And I just wanted to be different. I just wanted to be the one everybody talks about. I wanted to be the one where he's like, oh my God, I got one. Perfect. Yes, I'm the one. Believe in me. Let's go. Here's my credit card. Here's my life. Like, take me. You know, like really, I wanted to be that person. And so that's why I did it. And guess what happened? This one thing, I did that once. It was almost an unfair trade. Because here we are today, 11 years later. And I'm still telling the same story. Think about that. I did it once, but I get to tell the story for the rest of my life. That's what you call leverage in network marketing. That's what you call not catching the minimum disease. Okay? When you do things differently, when you think bigger, that's where leadership shows. That's who we need to be. The question is not what's the minimum we have to do. The question is what is the maximum we can duplicate? What is the maximum we can achieve? Right? That's the question. So this is very, very important. And one more thing. The minimum disease also gets fueled in network marketing like crazy because people just have a weak belief about this business. Let's face it, weak belief. If you want to open a McDonald's and you go somewhere and you ask, hey, can I have a McDonald's license? And they say, sure, it's $1.4 million or whatever it is, right? And then you say, oh my God, but I only have $120,000. What are they going to say? Are they going to be like, oh my God, we're so sorry. And don't worry about it. We have a really mini, tiny little Twinkie little McDonald's for you, like customized. Like you'll just have a hamburger and cheeseburger. You won't really have any of our premium burgers in your McDonald's. You won't really have a Big Mac or anything like that. But hey, at least you can put like a little sign and you have like only like a, you know, 3-seater and stuff, but we can kind of make that work. Is that what's going to happen? No. They're just going to be like, okay, fine. Come back when you got the money. In fact, we have a waiting list of people that want to do it. They don't care. Do you really think they care? Try any franchise, any normal business, anything. You want to open a Subway. Perfect. Go there. Say you don't have the money. They're just going to be like, so why are you talking to us then? They don't care. Here's what they don't do. They don't minimize their opportunity to fit the prospect. They're looking for people that are the right people to build their business. That's what we should do. But what do? Our business is already the most inexpensive in the world. There's no business in the world you can start for $1,000, $2,000, $3,000. If you live in Dubai, any normal business here, you need a license. My license, I just renewed my license here at the free zone, okay? Thousands of dollars every year. I just renewed my, think about this. When you have a business license here in Dubai, you need also an office. Even you don't need an office, you need an office. It's like a legal thing, right? And if you don't really need an office, then you can have at least like a virtual office, and a virtual office is cheaper. I just renewed it for 1 year. The virtual office, the desk somewhere that I never even saw, 20,000 dirhams. Just paid it. Just today paid it. 20,000 dirhams. I translate that into real money. that's about, wait, let me tell you guys, 20,000 divided by 3.665. We're talking $5,400, okay? So today I paid $5,400 to renew an office that I don't even need. That's real business. Network marketing, it's a joke when you look into the investments. So already our business is $1,000, $1,200, $1,500, $2,000, whatever. It's already nothing, right? And yet, what is it that we do? We still try to minimize it. We say, look, I got started with 1,200, but if you can do it, you can do 600. And then this guy does 600, and then his people say, oh, 600, that's really too much. I can't do that. Is there something smaller? Yeah, we can do the jumbo, like 300. And then that guy gets started with 300, and then his friends say, well, 300, I don't have $300. Can we do something smaller? And you say, sure, we got the basic pack, 200. Perfect. And then they get started with the basic pack. And here we have it again. The minimum disease is in full swing. And now we have the basic pack people running around telling people, hey, how about starting with the basic pack? And you know what these people say? Do I have to order anything? Or could I just sign up? I mean, I could just be like an associate, right? I mean, I could do like $30 and then kind of see. I mean, I'm in Jeunesse, but I don't really need products, right? It's not like I have to use them, right? And then you do that. And then at some point you're like, man, I hate this money part about the business. Wouldn't it be so cool if it was free? I tell you one thing, be careful what you wish for. In my journey, I was part of a company before I became successful where sign up was literally free. And guess what happened? People still found something to bitch about. To complain about. And they said things like, yeah, but do I really have to put my data in here? Like my real data? Because can I trust this company? I don't really want to leave my personal data on this website. I was like, are you serious right now? Right? So here's the truth. It goes always lower by itself. It goes always smaller by itself. People find always the natural ways to make things smaller. One person buys one serum and the other person says, hey, can you give me half of that? I'm telling you. And it's those people that will give you the most problems. It's not the one signing up with big belief, big pack and everything that's going to give you like a nonsense conversation. It's the person that didn't risk anything that's going to give you all the headache. True or true? How many can confirm that that's exactly what happens? Exactly. The stupid conversations. Why doesn't the serum close? And why did the company not ship me chocolate? Why did I get vanilla? And why is the shipping $3 more? And what? This conversations is coming from the people with the minimum disease. Those are the symptoms. Negativity, small thinking, no success, and a circle of people that bring the same thing. If one person's infected, infecting everybody else. So you got to avoid the minimum disease. And you do that by thinking bigger. You want big results. You need to raise your standard. Okay? Next thing. Qualify for everything. You have to qualify for everything. I do not care if you find the promotion exciting or not. You know, if the company has a promotion or your upline does a promotion or anybody, your team does a promotion or an incentive, that's what I'm talking about, okay? And, you know, the average person will look at it like this. Oh, wow, cool. There's a promotion. That's awesome. I want to have it. Let's try. Maybe I can qualify, right? But as a leader, it should be different. Your approach should be this. There's a promotion. I'll qualify. I don't care. It's a trip to, guess what? Here's a cool example. So we got some people from Dubai online, right? And the last travel incentive was to where? To where? You tell me. Dubai, right? And we were like, what? Like, I don't want to have a trip to my home. Like, I'm already here, right? So what did most people do from Dubai? They were like, yeah, I mean, that doesn't really make any sense. I mean, I'm already here, right? So I don't really need to qualify for this. But that's unprofessional. I'm telling you, you have to qualify for everything. Why? Because your attitude towards the promotion will infect others. Everything you do will infect others. You should be the first to qualify. you should qualify for everything. The company is giving away a free sports bag and you really don't need it or you don't even like it, then you know what? Guess what? Qualify for it and give it to somebody that loves it. But the truth is you need to qualify. It's part of building a professional business and it's a key to excellence because I need you to show up on every qualification at the top as the first person. New qualification, who's the first one qualified? Boom. This guy already qualified. Again, he qualified. And you need to be an example of your team. And by building from incentive to incentive, you can build a massive business. Most people completely underestimate the power of incentives. Jeunesse is a company that is one of the strongest companies in the world to work with incentives. You look at what's happening just right now with the special packages, with promotional points, you know, with products and pre-order in Europe, at least at this part, right? We have the $15,000 cash promotion. We have different regional promotions that are running. There is so much money being invested. I mean, literally millions of dollars that are being invested into the business right now, that if you do not take full advantage of that, it's crazy. Like you're literally crazy if you don't do that. And I'm telling you, most people, they say, oh my God, that's so many promotions. I don't even understand like why so many. That's the reality, what I'm telling you right now. Yeah, man, I don't think I can qualify. Do you know what's the number one reason why people don't qualify? Is because they think they can't. It has absolutely nothing to do with reality. It is before you even play, you kind of already decided you're not going to qualify. Because qualifying for something starts with the decision to do it. You have to decide to qualify. And the next thing you have to do is you have to research and understand the incentive. You have to look at the incentive. Okay, how does it work? How do I qualify? What are my questions? Get the answers. And then take it and teach it to your team. And then identify people in your team that they can qualify and then inspire them and motivate them and talk to them and make special groups and tell them, listen, we're in this group, the four of us, we're all going to qualify. Let's give each other our word. We're all going to qualify. Let's be an example for the team. The four of us, we're going to qualify. This is how you leverage money that the company is giving. Because for many of you, the company is paying millions of dollars, but like very little of this money is ending up in your team. How about making an incentive really expensive for Jeunesse? I love that idea. Oh, they have an incentive? Perfect. Let's make it really expensive for them this time. Right? I always try, and I think you see that we do so much around incentives, like we do trainings and meetings and calls, and we talk about it, and we make plans and all that, because I really want a lot of that investment to end up in your guys' pocket, in all our team's pockets. I want all of our team to qualify. And this is something, but as a leader, you need to go first. So qualify for everything. Don't ever say, oh, I can't do that. That's too hard. Oh, no, this one is not for me. Oh, this one. Oh, I've been there before. I don't want to be there. Or whatever it is. Or you know, cool example for the Middle East. You have a travel incentive and you need a visa and you know you can't even get one. That's a prime example, actually. Many people in our team from the Middle East, they know when the travel promo hits that most likely, even if they qualify, they won't be able to go. Now that sucks, right? If you think about it, that's really a bad example. And now you can tell a big story about why things are unfair and why you can't do it and why you can't qualify. But the result of this conversation cannot be that you don't qualify. How inspiring if you give everything you can to qualify to be at the top of the list and then you tell the story and guys, I qualified and guess what? I knew from day one I wouldn't be able to go, but I qualified. That's what it was about, to inspire my team and help others to qualify. Now people be like, wow, she's crazy. Exactly, right? That's it. You know, one of my friends here from the Middle East, Waleed, he's never been to the US. He has a Jordanian passport. He can't go to the US. And every time he tries, he's not getting a visa. And I told him, listen, man, second passport. It's coming. You can do that. You can literally get nationality. Did you know that? You can get a nationality from like a Caribbean country or something. It's like $200,000, $220,000 investment in St. Nevis and kids or something. Like, the average person would never think so far. They would never be like, what? I'm not paying $220,000 to get a second passport. But hey, your network marketing, you can change your life. And for some people, it's a little bit harder than for others. But hey, isn't that a dream worth fighting for? For him, that one thing is a dream. You know what I mean? And he's going to get it. I see the day he's going to get a second passport and he's going to have visa-free travel to 143 countries. But guys, that's what it is. Do you know what I mean? You have to qualify for everything. This one, have faith, is another key, a key to excellence. You have to believe. If you lose belief, that's the beginning of the end. You need to keep believing. And this is not just some thing where you say, all right, fine, I'll keep believing. No, keeping the faith and keeping belief is actual work. It requires daily input. You need to listen daily to audios, videos, stories, things that inspire you, examples, people, surrounding, environment. It's important. You cannot be in an environment where everything you hear every day is it's not going to work. Because you can be the strongest person, but one day you'll believe it's not going to work. And when you lose belief, that's it. Okay? When I was a child, we had a fireplace at our house. So my parents, to save money, we wouldn't use the heater. In Germany, you need a heater. In Dubai, we have an air condition, okay? But in Germany, we have a heater because it gets cold. So we need to heat it up rather than cool it down. And we didn't use the heater because it was expensive because of the gas, right? So what we did is we put fire, like wood in the oven to make the fire. And I remember every night we would put wood on the fire. And at some point I would go to bed, and in the morning I'd wake up to go to school. And in the morning, when I passed by the fireplace, I always found it fascinating how, like, hours later, there was still the coals, or the wood that kind of turned into being black coals, the ones that were sticking together, they were still glowing. Hours later, I always found that fascinating. Whatever is around was already dark and cold, but whatever was sticking together in the middle of it, in the middle of the community, okay, where the fire was in, it was kept alive. And it's such a great picture for all of us. You can be glowing like on full fire. If you're by yourself, you're going to cool down. So you need to get the right input in order to keep the fire alive and to keep the faith alive and to believe. Because the one who believes he can do it, or the one who believes he can't, they're both usually right. And don't give me this thing about, oh, but around me there is nobody that's working and I'm the only one and I can't do it and I wish I could spend 24/7 hours with somebody that's working. Guys, we live in the day and age of YouTube, podcasts, interviews, books that you can get for cents. You can feed your brain with the right mentality 24/7 at literally no cost. So no excuses. Don't say, don't focus, don't talk about what you don't have. Work with what you do have, okay? And ultimately, you can achieve your dreams. If you follow those six steps, those six keys, and really put them into reality, then you can really achieve your dreams. In this business, in Jeunesse, to be very specific, you can achieve levels of success that they're beyond imagination. Look, this is a picture of the house that I'm in right now. This is my home, okay? One of the two villas. I have actually another one right next to it, and it's still in construction process, as you can see. I look at this picture and I'm thinking, wow, that's a badass villa. And it's crazy to understand that it's mine. And it's just one out of many investments that we've done through network marketing. And when I remember when I got started and I couldn't even afford to use my own protein shake because I didn't have the money, it's quite humbling to see what this business, the results that this business can create. The power in this business comes from duplication. It comes from building an organization, a community. But in order to ever have that or get that, you need to become the leader. The leader needs to operate at an excellent level. The keys to that we discussed today. So I hope you took some good notes. I hope you're going to apply them. I hope you loved this this meeting and this hour, and you're going to share it with your teams. We did do a recording. I'll distribute it, hopefully, if I can get my hands on it. And again, thank you so much for Rahma for the French translation and for Leonor for the Portuguese translation. I hope you guys have a wonderful night, and let's make it happen. We're in the middle of the 90-day run, day 25 today. There's still so much more what we can do, so much more that we can achieve. So ultimately, I hope that you are going to take full advantage. All the best and have a great night. Thanks, everyone.